everyone. So today I'm going to be showing you how to depot lipstick. You're going to need something in which you're going to be putting in the lipstick. I'm going to be applying this in my MAC palettes. Basically, I'll talk about this later. You're going to be able to check out the review on my website. Okay, so you're going to need some kind of palette to put in your lipstick. You're going to need a metal spatula, a clean metal spatula, or actually a sterilized metal spatula. You're going to need Q-tips. I do recommend wearing rubber gloves when doing this so that it's sterile as possible, but you can still wash your hands and just be careful of what you touch so you don't transfer anything on it. You're going to need preferably a metal or sterile plate. I prefer metal because it's easier to keep it clean and it's more antibacterial. So you gotta sterilize it also. You can do that with alcohol. And you're also going to need a lipstick. So we're gonna be depotting my Wet n Wild lipsticks. You're also going to need a little bit of alcohol, which I have applied in this shot glass. Make sure that it's not too deep, that it's deep enough so you can actually dip in your Q-tip and clean. So the first thing you wanna do is make sure that everything you're going to use is sterile. So I'm going to show you here. You want to make sure that you pick up some alcohol with your Q-tip, and you're going to be cleaning inside and out. You're going to be cleaning where you're going to be applying the lipsticks. I'm going to be applying on the bottom the names of the lipsticks so that I know what they are, and so that it's clear right here, so that I have a very good view of what lipsticks are in here without destroying this here. The next thing is basically using your lipstick. When you're going to be transferring the lipstick that was in here, a lipstick that you're using from a tube into one of these palettes, make sure that this is a lipstick that you have never ever put directly on anyone's lips. As you can see, this is a lipstick which I have always taken a spatula, took some off, put it on one of my metal plates, and then use it on clients. That's the safest thing. There's a way that you can do it with most lipsticks, is that you take the lipstick right there, you take it by the red part, and you slowly wiggle it out. But since my Wet n Wild isn't really doing anything like that, I'm going to be just taking, make sure that this is sterile. Also, I'm going to be just cutting off like this for a start. I'm not sure how much can fit in, so less is always more. I'm going to be pushing it, like cutting it up like this. This is the first time actually doing it in a palette like this. And if you cut it up like this, you make it mushy, and then it's much easier to control. Don't worry about like us getting the rims dirty and stuff like that. We'll resolve that later. And some of you might be asking me like, or thinking, why am I not heating the lipstick up and then just kind of melting it into the pot? That's faster, that's easier. That might be true, but the thing you have to consider is that what happens to lipstick when you heat it up? When you heat up a lipstick, there is a big possibility, especially with lipsticks that have any form of glitter inside, there's a big possibility that you're going to contaminate the actual ingredient or the texture of the lipstick. What means that the lipstick in its formula might separate and never connect again, let's call it like that, due to high forms of heat. And then some of you would be like, that's not really that high. And that's true too, but I think that it's better not to risk it, to be honest. I think it's best to kind of be on the safe side and not damage your makeup. And as you can see, it looks great for now. So what we want to do, and this is me doing this first time, I'm just gonna take a clean tissue. And first, I'm just gonna wipe it like this just to see how high I have pushed this lipstick, because if I overfilled it, it's not going to be good. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take this tissue, sorry, I'm not showing it, take this tissue, and I'm going to press it over like this, like that. And with my finger, I'm just gonna lightly dab like that. And what I'm doing here is, since my finger is flat as possible, I'm actually trying to secure that all the product is evenly pushed into the hole where we're putting it. But again, don't over push, because if you push too hard, it's going to go over. So just lightly push, and then we're gonna pull over, yes, you're going to be picking up some product, you're going to be losing, but in this way, we're sure that we kind of got all the product pushed in properly. So what you can do, I'm sorry, I just forgot to mention, we're going to take a tissue, put it here at the bottom, and we're going to flip this over. And remember, our lipstick, sorry, it's a little bit dirty right there. Our lipstick is on that side right there, so we're going to flip it over. And right there, we want to apply the sticker. So on the bottom of this, you have a sticker right there. And we're going to sterilize this spatula again, so don't worry about us touching it with our fingers. We're going to be trying to take off that sticker. Just, oh no, it's ripping. Oh, I really want to use this sticker. Maybe like when you buy your lipstick right away, maybe it's much easier to take off this sticker, but it's not going. But slowly we're going to go in a little circle. That, there we go. Yay, got it all. Okay, so let me just double check again. Okay, right there. So we're going to be taking that and bam, pushing it like that. And there we go. Now we know exactly what palette is there. And pushing it like that is going to make me see that we have some residue right there. Opening it up. There we go, right? And now we're going to take this, flop it over. Okay, looks so far so good. Close it. Gonna lightly tap it on the table. We're gonna open it. Voila. All right, guys, this completes it. Thank you guys so much for watching. When I'm done depotting my lipstick, I'm going to be uploading on my website a picture of how it looks. So that is it. Thank you guys so much once more. Take care. Bye, guys.